Welcome to Army National Guard's 3-Minute Doctrine. In January of 1945, the 161st Infantry Washington Army National Guard landed on the island of Luzon in the Philippines as part of a massive invasion. After several months of hard fighting, they found themselves at the base of the Balete Pass, a small gap in the mountains outside the town of Santa Fe. These positions were heavily occupied by the Japanese Army, and the 25th Division Commander directed his subordinate leaders to conduct an envelopment of the enemy defense. The envelopment is one of the 6 forms of maneuver identified in Army doctrinal publications. According to Army doctrine, the 6 forms of maneuver are the envelopment, turning movement, frontal attack, penetration, infiltration, and flank attack. Combined arms organizations accomplish their mission by synchronizing the contributions of all warfighting functions to execute these forms of maneuver. So what does an envelopment mean? FM 1-02.1, Operational Terms, provides common language descriptions of the tasks and maneuvers to make up larger Army doctrine. If you're looking to understand something described in another publication, Operational Terms is the place to check. According to the FM, the envelopment is a form of maneuver in which an attacking force seeks to avoid the principal enemy defenses by seizing objectives behind those defenses that allow for a targeted enemy force to be destroyed in their current positions. At the tactical level, envelopments focus on seizing terrain, destroying specific enemy forces, and interdicting enemy withdrawal routes. The commander's decisive operation focuses on attacking an assailable flank. It avoids the enemy's strength, the enemy's front, where the effects of the enemy fires and obstacles are the greatest. If no assailable flank is available, then the attacking commander can create one with a penetration. There are a few types of envelopments. A single envelopment results from maneuvering around one assailable flank of a designated enemy force. Double envelopments result from simultaneous maneuvering around both flanks of an enemy force. Encirclement operations are operations where one force loses its freedom of maneuver because an opposing force is able to isolate it by controlling all ground lines of communication and reinforcement. Vertical envelopments are tactical maneuvers where troops, either airdropped or air-landed, attack the rear and flanks of a force, in effect cutting it off and encircling it. A successful envelopment depends largely on the degree of surprise a commander achieves against the opponent or the presence of overwhelming combat power. The probability of success also increases when the commander's forces have superior tactical mobility, possessing air and information superiority, and shaping operations to fix the bulk of the enemy forces in their current position. For these reasons, the envelopment is a preferred tactic of highly mobile units, such as striker, air assault, and airborne. To defeat Japanese forces in the area, the 25th Division attempted a double envelopment. After bringing into play his additional assets, including additional fixing forces, engineers, artillery, and anti-aircraft units repurposed in a direct fire role, the commander of the 25th Division ordered the 161st Infantry to flank again. The 161st Infantry made their attack from a new position and was able to work their way around Japanese forces occupied by the fixing force and successfully enveloped the pass, opening Highway 5 north to Santa Fe in May of 1945. To make their attack successful, the 161st Infantry displayed the key elements of conducting an envelopment. 161st avoided the principal defenses by seizing objectives around those defenses. They allowed the enemy force covering Highway 5 to be destroyed in their current positions, clearing the road north to Santa Fe. So when you're planning your next envelopment, remember to reference some doctrine and draw from the experience of those who came before us.